If we could possibly get it.
Ninth time Palmer has appeared in a World Series game, but never before as a relief pitcher.
You see the tears streaming down the eyes of a fan of Frank and Brooks and all the other Orioles. And the big move, listen to it. Made so many great memories here at Memorial Stadium. Orioles take the field officially for the first time in this new ballpark. It is official now. Cal Ripken has broken Lou Gehrig's record. New record.
They did it! The Orioles have beat the Red Sox!
Line drive. That is down. And 2-1. Party around third. He's going to try to score. And save.
This organization has in its DNA smartest, most forward-thinking, most progressive organization in baseball. And the fact that that has been the case here before means that it's possible for that to be the case here again.
Mullins into center field. This should do it. A clincher, a walk-off. The Orioles have done it. You are the new champions of the American League East.
I think we're really going to enjoy this next chapter.
No matter how much I try to ruin it, that gives you chills, doesn't it? Thank you, Mike. I speak on behalf of the entire organization and Birdland when I say we look forward to writing the next chapter of Oriole baseball with you. Before I go on, we missed a couple of people. I'd like to take this time to acknowledge Lieutenant Governor Aruna Miller. Thank you. And I will be remiss. Growing up in West Baltimore, listening to Oriole baseball on the radio, it was always Ripken and Murray. So we have to acknowledge Baseball Hall of Famers Cal Ripken. And of course, Eddie Murray. Governor Moore and Mr. Rubenstein, on behalf of the ownership group, will take questions from you. Now, before we go, I have to play the bad guy because we have time restraints. We have our manager will speak at noon, so we've got to get out of here in a few minutes. So, but if you have a question, we'll bring the microphone around to you for your question. Just raise your hand. Okay, all the way in the back.
Question for the governor. Actually, two questions. two questions. So first of all, regarding the bridge and the state legislators are introducing a bill that would protect wages for workers, among other things. Obviously, there is no existing funding for that. Do you have any expectations as to where that money will come from? Will it come from state coffers? And then I have a second question regarding fracture critical bridges in the state. Do you have any plans to evaluate and other fracture-critical bridges like the Francis Scott Key Bridge to ensure that this sort of thing doesn't happen again?
Yeah, so first on the workers, we have to make sure that our workers are protected. You know, when you're looking at the impact of the Port of Baltimore and what that bridge represents, we're talking about upwards of 8,000 workers. This is a core economic engine for our state, and we have to make sure that our workers are protected. I know there's a series of legislation that's been spoken about. There has not been language that's been produced yet. But the thing that we know is that we are going to work with the General Assembly, as the same way we're working with members of our federal delegation, on ensuring that that our workers are going to be protected in this time. On the critical infrastructure issue, it's absolutely right. I mean, when you look at the size and the enormity of the vessel that that hit the Key Bridge, when you're looking at a vessel of that size, and just yesterday, we were actually out. In fact, I was out with the mayor, with Senator Cardin, and we hopped on a Coast Guard cutter to get a close look. The size of that vessel is enormous. And when you're talking about a vessel moving at that speed, the difficulty of not just the Key Bridge, of frankly many bridges around the country being able to take that kind of direct impact was minimal. And so there is and there is going to be a true full evaluation. And again, not just of that, of just all of our key infrastructure that we have all around the state of Maryland. This is something that happens consistently around our state, but what happened with the Key Bridge is, you know, was an important reminder of the work and the task ahead.
Next question, Coleman. He needs a mic.
Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
Hi, Mr. Rubenstein. Jerry Coleman. Question for you regarding Camden Yards. There's been talk about naming rights for Camden Yards. Would love to know where that stands. And also trying to get an all-star game back to this stadium as well. Is that part of your efforts behind the scenes?
Well, the all-star games have already been allocated for the next few years. I think the earliest we could probably do it is 2028 or 7. Yeah, it's 27. Yeah, so it's going to take a while. It's something we're obviously interested in. We hope by that time the stadium will be rehabilitated a bit, and therefore we'd like to show it off. So once we have the rehabilitated Camden Yards, I think it'd be a great time to then show it off. We want to make sure we have it completed, though. So we are interested in it, and I am familiar with the situation. And the naming rights, you know, there have been proposals for that. No decision is imminent, and I am familiar with the proposal that came forward. But, you know, it's something we'll take a look at. But nothing is going to happen immediately. And I have been in touch with those people that would like to do the naming, and I just have to follow up after we get the opening day things behind us. Let me just add, if I could, in our ownership group, we've tried to have a group of people that represent not just people that look like me, but we have people that, you know, come from all different kind of backgrounds. And we also have people that actually know how to play baseball, too. One of them is Cal Ripken. And if I could ask Cal to come up for one moment. Cal, could you speak for a moment why you're interested in being part of our ownership group? You know, he has a better feel for baseball than probably anybody that I know, with possible exception of Eddie Murray, who's right here. But Cal, tell us why you'd like to join.
I can give the mic to Eddie Murray, too.
Okay.
Okay. I'm not going to take much of your time. It's an exciting day for me personally. I got a nice new jacket. And I want to thank David and Michael for the opportunity to be part of the ownership group. I've loved the Orioles since I was about 5 years old. I remember my dad greeting all of the minor league the organization and saying, "Welcome to the greatest organization in baseball," and there was a pride to be an Oriole, the whole Oriole way. And then I dreamed about for the next 20 years about trying to become a Baltimore Oriole. And then luck would have it that I became a Baltimore Oriole for 21 years. And then I spent the last 20 years learning a little bit about business through owning an Oriole affiliate. And so timing is you're finding out plays a part in all our decisions and all things, how they work out. And this is a wonderful timing for me to be able to come back, be part of the Oriole organization, and help out in any way that I can. And so I'm really looking forward to that.
So you can see I was a Little League All-Star shortstop at age of 8 or 9, I think it was. And I didn't grow to be as tall as Cal Ripken. So, you know, if only I'd been a little taller, maybe I could have played for the Orioles. But, okay, we have a most valuable player here. And we have another most valuable partner, and that is our general manager, Mike. Do you have any comments? Would you like to say something?
Mike, come on up. I'll give you my mic.
Thanks for the heads up. Appreciate it.
Okay. Go ahead. Most valuable person, our general manager.
It's testing my spontaneity. What more is there to say? Governor Moore, great to have you here, and you know, we support everything that we do, and it's just been so nice getting to know you personally, and the support you give to our franchise and our city, of course, but is really personal, and it means a lot to us. So really appreciate everyone being here. Momentous occasion. I've really appreciated the warmth that I've received from the incoming owners, management, partners, and you know, this is a very bright day, very bright inflection point for our franchise. We all feel wonderful about where the Orioles are right now and where they're going, and you know, the success of our team is part and parcel with the success of not just the city, but the state too. So we take it all very seriously, and looking forward to enjoying the day, and hopefully we can be 1-0 in a few hours.
Yes. Yesterday we had a meeting with the professional employees here, and what I tried to say then is that those people that work in the front office and the back office are just as important as our players. Only if we have everybody united are we going to win a World Series. And I also asked them to pray for good weather today. And to show you that prayer does work, it looks like we're going to get the game off. So I want to thank all those who prayed yesterday of all religions, but obviously the weather gods heard us. So we're very pleased that we can actually have the game go forward, it looks like. Okay? Other questions? Yes. Yeah, here? Oh, Governor.
Thank you. Sir, have you, at this point in regard to the bridge collapse, has there been anything identified safety-wise that maybe should have been done that wasn't, or anything that needs to be put in place in the future?
No, I think everything and all the investigations are still very preliminary. And as more information comes out from the investigations, we'll get a better sense of what exactly happened. Both leading up to the crash and also anything that could have done to prevent it. But the thing that we know is the full commitment that we have, both from a state and also the commitment that we have from the federal government as well, is we are going to do anything and everything to make sure that our people are protected, that our people are safe, and that our transportation and our infrastructure assets are the best in the world.
Mr. Rubenstein, if I may, obviously Baltimore runs through your veins. Can you talk to us about your reaction when you first saw the news of the Key Bridge collapsing, and then separately, speaking to the governor's point of how important the team is to rebuilding a city, down in D.C., the Caps and the Wizards are going to stay in the city, but at one point they were going to move to Virginia, everyone thought. Can we get your reaction to Mr. Leonce's deciding to stay in the District of Columbia?
My reaction to the bridge? Is that what you're...
First, yes.
First. Oh, the same reaction any human would have. It's a tragic situation, and obviously particularly terrible for those people who happened to be at the bridge at the time, the tragic loss of life. But it's an unfortunate situation as well for the economic strength of the community, because it's been a very important bridge. So, it does remind everybody that infrastructure is so important to our country, and having strong, fresh, new infrastructure is important. This bridge, I'm not an expert on how it was constructed, but clearly, it was a shock that what happened, let's put it that way. So I have the same reaction every human being has, which is a tragic loss that happened, something very sad.
And then so the Caps and the Wizards?
I'm sorry?
The Caps and the Wizards?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Oh, okay. What can I say? I'm not an owner of that team. I do know Ted Leonsis well, and Glenn Youngkin used to work at my firm, and before he became governor of Virginia. I think being a partner in my firm is a better thing than being governor of Virginia, but not better than being governor of Maryland, though. But I think Glenn structured a deal that I guess it seems as if didn't have the complete support of the legislature, but I'm not familiar with the details. And I think the people in the District of Columbia are quite happy with the result that we now have. And I applaud the mayor for going back and getting that done. And I applaud Ted for being willing to reverse course and get something done that everybody in the Washington metropolitan area is pleased with, in my view.
I'm sorry, folks, we're out of time right now. As we said, we had time restraints. This is the end of our Q&A session. Thank you all for coming. Lots more Oriole baseball and opening day festivities for the rest of the day. Can we have the rest of the ownership group up on the stage for a photo?